In the U.S., Kobe Bryant's widow, Vanessa, awarded $16 million in damages as part of a $31 million jury verdict against the Los Angeles County Sheriff and Fire Departments. The lawsuit stems from the release of graphic photos of the helicopter crash that killed the basketball star and their daughter, Gianna, in January 2020. The photos included images of the wreckage as well as the mangled remains of the victims. During the trial, witnesses revealed some of the first responders showed the photographs to the public. The jury found Vanessa Bryant suffered emotional distress as a result. 22 people are killed in a Russian strike on a Ukrainian railway station Wednesday. The tragic incident comes as Kyiv marks 6 months of war with Moscow. The country was also celebrating the 31st anniversary of its independence from the Soviet Union. To mark the occasion, the United States announced $2.98 billion in new military assistance to Ukraine.
His theory of victory is that he can wait everybody out. He can wait the Ukrainians out because they'll be exhausted and attrited. He can wait us out because we'll turn our attention elsewhere. He can wait the Europeans out because of high energy prices or whatever. And so packages like this are extraordinarily important in directly challenging Putin's theory of the case, which is that we're not in it for the long haul.
The fresh aid comes as Washington claims Moscow could begin announcing referenda designed to formalize its control of occupied parts of Ukraine as soon as this week. The White House believes Moscow will try to manipulate the results of the voting to falsely claim that Ukrainians want to join Russia. The U.S. and Iran close to reaching an agreement to resurrect the 2015 nuclear deal. The U.S. says it has sent to the European Union its response to Iran's comments on the EU's draft proposal. The EU earlier this month submitted what it called a final text of the proposal after more than a year of negotiations. The document aims to fully restore the nuclear deal by bringing the U.S. back into it after former U.S. President Donald Trump withdrew America from the pact in 2018. U.S. President Joe Biden announces $10,000 in student loan relief for millions of debt-saddled graduates, keeping a promise he made during the campaign trail. But it falls far short of the goal of some Democrats, securing complete debt forgiveness. U.S. colleges can cost between $10,000 and $70,000 a year, leaving graduates with crushing debt as they enter the workforce. The average debt for U.S. college students when they graduate is $25,000, a sum many spend years or even decades to pay back.
My campaign for president, I made a commitment. I made a commitment that would provide student debt relief, and I'm honoring that commitment today. Using the authority Congress granted the Department of Education, we will forgive $10,000 in outstanding federal student loans. In addition, students who come from low-income families, which allowed them to qualify to receive a Pell Grant, will have their debt reduced $20,000. Both of these targeted actions are for families who need it the most, working and middle-class people hit especially hard during the pandemic, making under $125,000 a year.
Now, while the move boosts support for Biden's fellow Democrats in November's midterm elections, some Republicans are questioning if he had the authority to cancel the debt. Some economists also fear it may further fuel inflation, as it will free up billions of dollars for new consumer spending.